how to add a picture to video using Veed. So let's say you have a video and you want to add a picture to it. You want to add two pictures, even three pictures, as many pictures as you want. Well, in this video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how to add a picture to your video, as well as changing the location of that picture on the video and the time and duration that it shows up for during the video. So the tool we're going to be using is called Veed. So you can either Google Veed, which is V-E-E-D, and then click on the first link. If not, as usual, the link's going to be in the description down below. Once you're on Veed, if you don't already have an account, you'll be prompted to create a new one for free. And if you do have an account, we're just going to click on the new project button, and then we'll be taken into Veed's video editor. And this is where we want to upload our video. And to do so, we're just going to click on the upload video button. Now our documents pop up, and we're just going to select the video that we want to upload and then click on open. As we can see, it's now imported into Veed's timeline, and we can see the progress of the upload in the top right of the video editor. So to add a picture to our video, it's very straightforward. In the left toolbar, we're going to click on the image tab, and then here we have the add image button, and we're going to click on it. And then again, our documents will open, and here we need to select the image that we want to upload. So I've got a few images here, and I'm going to select this podcast logo right here, and I select it and click on open. And as we can see, it's now imported onto our video canvas. So to move it around on the video canvas, all I have to do is just click and drag. If I want to rotate it, I just click this rotate icon at the top and just rotate it around. If I want to resize it, I click on any of these pink dots and resize it. And if I want to keep the dimensions the same, so I want to keep the 1:1 aspect ratio, I just need to make sure that I hold down shift when I do so. As you can see, it now stays consistent. Now I'm going to click and drag and place it, let's just say, in the top left. And if I click play, hey everyone, I hope you're all doing great. As you can see, my image is in the top left corner. Welcome to the social media. If I want to add a second image, very simple again, I just click on the add image button. And then again, I'm just going to select this one this time. So it's a picture of me, and I'm just going to place it in the bottom left, just like so. And I'm just going to point to this podcast logo, just like this. Now, what happens if I don't want the pictures to last throughout the entire video? Well, if we take a look for both images, so we've got our podcast picture and then the cutout of me picture, we have timings. We have the start time and the end time. And as you can see, if we take a look at our timeline, it begins at zero and it ends at, let's see, it ends at 12.3. And as we can see, both pictures end at 12.3. So let's say I want the podcast image to finish halfway through. I can just click and drag this. And let's just say I want it to end at 4.3. I let go at 4.3. And as you can see, if I bring the playhead here and then I click play,
your podcast, I'm your host, Alec.
As you can see, it disappears. What I'm going to do is just drag out my timeline just a little bit so I can see the timeline better. And you don't have to just click and drag like this. You can also enter the time manually. So if I want to be precise and I say I want it to finish at 8.9, all I have to do is just type that in with the keyboard. And there we go. Same thing for the start time. I could enter, let's just say I want to begin at 5, so it's only going to be appearing for 3.9 seconds. As we can see, if I drag this back and I click play.
Just Alec, and in this podcast, we're going to be talking about everything and anything related to social media, so get comfortable.
The picture appears and disappears. Now I can do the same thing for the cutout of me, but I also want to show you that you don't have to edit the time and duration straight from here. You can also directly just click and drag the actual image within the timeline. So if I want this to be displayed at the same time as me, all I have to do is just click and drag right here. And now both pictures will appear at the same time.
And in this podcast, we're going to be talking about everything and anything related to social media. So get
now you can add as many pictures as you want. You just need to click on the add image button again. And then again, to move them around and change the duration, very simple. Just click and drag them around in your timeline. You can make one appear above the other. For example, if I want this podcast icon to be behind me, all I have to do is just drag this over myself. And then I could just fix it again by just clicking and dragging. And there you go. Remember, you can just rotate it just like this, resize. And once you're happy with your images, all you have to do is click on the export button in the top right to start rendering your video. And then once your video has finished rendering with its new images, you'll be able to download it straight to your computer. And that is how to add a picture to your video online using Veed. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed this video and you found it helpful, please hit the like button, the subscribe button, and notification bell. Thanks for watching.